Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the next video on Jetpack Compose. In the previous video, what we have done is we created basically a view model and we moved all the logic from the composable that we had written here into the view model, and then we created an instance of view model here and passed it as a constructor parameter to the main screen composable. And when we ran this, we were basically able to successfully do the increment and decrement operation. So the whole motivation that we started with, wherein we wanted to keep our composable logic strictly UI related and move all the business related logic to a view model, that we have been able to achieve successfully. But there is a problem that we have not paid attention to. And that is, if I increment it here and then change the configuration, then it is once again getting reset to zero. We had actually solved this particular problem when we were using a normal remember mutable state of. But with the view model, it seems to have broken that piece of the logic. Now, how do we make sure that this view model doesn't get reset? And there is a solution. Actually, there are multiple solutions, but I am going to show you probably one of the most simple one that I typically follow. Well, the view model that comes with the Jetpack is already lifecycle aware. When I say lifecycle aware, I am basically talking about the main activity lifecycle, the on create, on start, on pause, on restart, all those things. So if we initialize this view model at the appropriate place in the main activity, since it is lifecycle aware, it should be able to maintain its state automatically. So what we will do is, instead of creating it here, we will initialize it as a private variable of the main activity. It need not be private, but that's just a convention. So private val main activity view model, and then we will initialize it by view models and main activity view model. This is just a constructor. So we just have a main activity view model here, and this we pass here. And now that's it. If I run this, I increment it, and then if I change the orientation, it retains its state and you can continue to increment it. And if I once again change the state, it retains the state. So that's it. So whatever the logic that had broken after we had moved the business logic to the view model, it has been fixed now. The only modification that we have done is we have initialized it as a private variable, that is view model, and then passed that view model as the argument. We have not touched even a single line of code that is inside the main screen composable. The only thing that is now left is, if the counter reaches zero, it should not go in a negative direction. We have to probably just show some kind of a error. Now, how do we do that? That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.